might be. Good thing she ran out of money and had to send in the hay wagon.
Oh, little Joe, you know perfectly well I needed every one of these
things. I'm sure you did, Connie. Stay to supper.
I don't think so. I'm going to show my face around the Ponderosa. Even if you get home ever, they finally start charging me for the board.
He'll change his mind. I'm going to put these things upstairs, then I'll be down to cook some for Dad.
Understand. She's a pretty good cook. You got a wonderful girl, Mr. Mckee. That's what I always wanted to be. And I wanted to talk to you about Connie. What's on your mind?
Yes, sir. Connie and I have known each other for a long time. I knew, sir.
Yes, you have. Quite a long time.
And I know you've probably heard a lot of stories about me. All about me and old Virginia City. Right? I just wanted you to know that they didn't mean a thing to me, not any of
them. I hope you didn't tell them that at the time.
No, sir, not at the time. But anyway, that's not the way it is with Connie and me. I'm very fond of her, sir. And if Connie will have me, what I'm trying to say is, sir, I'd like to ask her to marry me.
I don't think there's any way I can keep it from asking her.
Does that mean you'd rather I wouldn't?
I don't mean that at all. All I ever want is for Connie to be happy. And the chances other girls have.
So that's what I made to offer.
Sometimes when you all about yourself, you should.
I'm sorry I upset you, sir. Again, not long ago. Tell Connie I'll see you soon.
And the wonder of it that you're about ready to explode. And then you get married.
You know, like we talked about, selling all this, heading east, you were so dead set on that when you first got here.
I know, but I didn't realize then.
You thought you couldn't be happy out here when you first got
here. That's what I didn't realize. The geography has nothing to do with happiness. Dad. I know why you were talking about selling out and going east. I'll always love you a whole lot more because you were doing it for me.